closer to that moment when perhaps Sergeant Crowley and Professor Gates would be patching this thing up together. But I tell you what, it just feels like the divide, if it started here, it just got wider and wider and wider with each comment. What are your thoughts in the room?
Yeah, I'm surprised that you thought that. I mean, Tony, you've been doing this just as long as I have. Yeah. I knew that there would be some fallout after it was told to me that the Superior Officers Association was going to have a press conference. I think they are very concerned with Gates' comments after the incident. They feel that it's been very one-sided, you know, to be honest with you, in the media about Gates. You've been hearing about Gates, but you haven't been hearing that much about the officer. Part of that, though, is the department's own fault, because they haven't really been transparent or allowing any of their officers to talk, and they didn't want Sergeant Crowley to speak as well. But as you saw, just the sense of the community, as I got here yesterday and I went directly to the police department, you could sort of feel it in the air. The police commissioner said to me, morale is low here.
Yeah.
And it was, it was better before the president made his comments.
Well, Don, can I say something?
Even lower after that, because it got even lower after that, because they thought that this was going to go away after a while, after the news cycle. But then once the president responded to it, they feel that it brought it back up again, and not only brought it back up, amped it up to a different level.
I get that, but here's my point. This is incendiary. Yeah. Race in this country is powerfully incendiary.
Yeah.
And I suppose I thought that both sides of this would take a step back, not listen to the news cycle, not base future comments on the last news cycle, and make a determination that race is such let me finish the thought, is such a powerful factor in this country that it would be better to take a step back and try to figure out a way to mend this.
Yeah.
Not deepen it.
That's what advisors on both sides are saying. Advisors from outside on both sides are saying, hey, listen, guys, tone down
the rhetoric. Take down the temperature on this.
Take down the temperature on this and relax a little. Because, you know, the law enforcement community, we know it is a community that bands together. It's very vocal. They're very protective and insular of their own, as well they should be, as well most people are. And the same thing when you're talking about race, and especially African-American men and their relationship to police officers. I mean, most African-American men in this country have had some sort of incident, perceived or real, about feelings about being racially profiled.
Okay, and let me stop. Yeah, let me tee it up, Don. Let me tee it up. Here's the thing, and I say this because I want us to conduct this discussion here with total transparency. I know.